went down to the River Jordan, where John baptized three.
Whereas on the 22nd day of September A.D. 1862, a proclamation was issued by the President of the United States containing, among other things, the following to wit, that on the first day of January 1863, all persons held as slaves within each state or designated part of the state, the people whereof shall then be in rebellion against the United States and shall then, thenceforth and forever be free. And the executive government of the United States, including the military and naval authority thereof, will recognize and maintain the freedom of such persons and will do no act or acts to repress such persons or any of them in any efforts they may make for their actual freedom. This day in rebellion against the United States and following, Arkansas, Texas, Louisiana, Assumption, including the territories of New Orleans, Mississippi, Alabama, Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, and Virginia, except the 48 counties designated as West Virginia, and also the counties of Berkeley, Accomack, Elizabeth City, York, Princess Anne, and Norfolk, including the cities of Norfolk and Portsmouth, and which excerpted parts are for the present left precisely as this proclamation were issued. And by virtue of the power and for the purpose aforesaid, I do order and declare that all persons held as slaves within said designated states and parts of the states are and henceforth shall be free. And the executive government of the United States, including the military and naval authorities, therefore will recognize and maintain the freedom of such persons.
This community has meant a lot to us. And Carlos's wife, Lori, is here. And I spoke with her a little bit about what it means to her. And I wrote it down. And she said, she told me it's family. You get married, and you're watching them raise, and you go through Katrina, and you watch it wash away. And then you pick yourself up, and you move 600 miles away in the middle of Central Texas. And then we run into the same thing when we get here. And y'all dealt with the same fires and devastation that we did. Family is what makes community. And that's why we're all here today. It's about family. Some of you read an email from me. If you ever gotten an email, I always put a little quote at the end in my signature. And there's three that are my favorites. And I'm going to read those today and maybe give a little explanation. But the first one needs absolutely no explanation. And it reads this way. If a person's Bible is falling apart, their life isn't. The second one comes from the aftermath of Katrina, the community that Carlos and I grew up in. And it reads this. We dance even when there's no radio. We drink at funerals. We talk too much. We laugh too loud. And we live life way too large. Frankly, we're suspicious of those who don't. The third is the bulk of my speech today. And it's a quote. That's what's past is prologue. It comes from Shakespeare. It's in a play, The Tempest. But more importantly, it's inscribed, engraved at the National Archives building in Washington, D.C. And indeed, we can look down this road in the future based on part of knowing where we have come from and where we are going. And a community defines who we are, the good and the bad. It's very important that we remember our past, the good and the bad, so that we may profit to know that nothing of the past has no future. And if you have no understanding of the present, you have little conception of what that future is. It's very important to see, as far as we can as a community, into our future. If you know what's going to happen, you can make sure life much better for yourself. And I think of those who have dedicated the idea of maintaining good records. But people who dedicate themselves to making sure that the past is told to their future. Where we come from, who we are, why we are, and making it possible for us to look into the future and see where we will be. So if you wonder what the saying past is prologue comes from, it simply means We better be prepared, because what we have gone through just may someday come around again. What you are and doing here today in this community and our Juneteenth celebration is a perfect example of that, of letting the future know where we came from in our past and what has defined us about our past, which will give us the opportunity to have better opportunities and make things more possible for our future. What you're doing here today in this community is unbelievable. And there's more possibilities and there's more understandings than ever before. And I thank you, for all of you, for Carlos and Lori, and I thank you very much. And I thank you for our employees who are our family, and I thank you very much. And I thank you for all of our children in the future, where your past helps define their future. I thank you and appreciate you very, very much. I thank you.
Went down to the River Jordan, where John baptized three, where I walked the devil in hell, says Johnny baptized me. I say, roll, Jordan, roll, roll, Jordan, roll. My soul will rise in heaven, Lord, for the year, Jordan, roll. Well, some say John was a Baptist.
Some say
John was a Jew. But I say John was a preacher, cause my Bible says so too. I say, roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul will rise in heaven, Lord, for the year of Jordan.